I got a serious question for everybody out there. I generally want to know this, okay? How is everybody making it? I just got his prescription. It was $1,000. I now have to go in and tell my 9-year-old son, I couldn't pay for it.
This is Katie. After staring down a bill for her son's insulin she couldn't afford, she hit a wall. Her frustration clearly struck a chord, racking up millions of views.
Am I the only one struggling? How are you guys doing it?
What do you think about that?
I don't even know what to say. The deadliest conflict in history is playing out and no one cares.
This team of biohackers think they're on the verge of a solution. By reverse engineering insulin, then sharing the instructions with the world.
Very few people really have any concrete ideas about how to solve these problems. At the level of the technical fundamentals, it's clear that we can do this. And if we can, we must.
This is Just Might Work, a show about surprising solutions to our biggest problems.
Good. When I was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes, it came as quite a surprise. And as time went on, I became more aware that my life was actually hanging from a very thin thread.
The price of insulin has been on the rise for years, but while prescription costs have skyrocketed, the cost to produce it is actually
remarkably low. $1.50 to $5 a vial. Because of the way the supply chain works or doesn't work in the United States, the list prices are $300 a vial and even more.
And that's in part because three companies own 90% of the world's insulin, and they've consistently matched each other's price increases.
Producers of medicine don't really face competition. Our work definitely aims to bring an end to that situation where people can produce medicine without facing any competition.
The big three manufacturers have introduced their own versions of generics. And even though it has reduced costs for the first time in a while, they're still unaffordable for many who need it.
The Open Insulin Project is an effort to make the means of producing insulin available to everyone who needs insulin.
Their plan to disrupt the market starts with figuring out how to make insulin, then sharing the instructions with everyone else. And that first part has proven to be pretty complicated. Jan can explain.
Insulin is particularly tricky. The insulin in this pro, we try to express it in E. coli, and glargine, we try to express it in yeast. You have to extract the protein, you have to purify the proteins. This is only the beginning.
Dozens of volunteers have been working for 6 years and are just now nearing a breakthrough.
We are able to produce insulin in the wet lab, and the science is really working. And we are really in a place that we are like, okay, we are getting close to get like a protocol that could be used to actually produce insulin that is injectable.
If it works, they estimate their insulin would be 98% cheaper.
The goal would be to measure the glucose intake of those cells, so you can have insulin cells with commercial insulin, and then you have cells with your insulin, and you look at how much glucose they can get.
Meaning their insulin would be able to safely and effectively regulate blood sugar just as well as commercial insulin.
And this would be the final proof that we managed to have functional insulin.
The FDA will approve the molecules, and actually the FDA have been changing the regulation around insulin because they want to open the market much more. That means that we are in the good track to make sure we have affordable insulin in the market soon.
But Open Insulin is a small team in a small lab. They know they can't make enough insulin for the millions that need it, so they're taking an open source approach. They don't anticipate people making DIY insulin in their kitchen, but they do envision sharing the protocol for producing insulin with community labs all over the world, for free, without restrictions. Basically provide the blueprint to set up their same operation anywhere.
Working at a smaller scale means that the supply chain is shorter and less complex.
Open Insulin is already working with volunteers across the US and around the world.
Our plans to have a system for local production that can operate anywhere in the world that there's a need for it.
What is great with Open Insulin is like it's international. these other countries around the world that don't even have access to insulin. It's not even that it's too expensive, it's just not there. If you depend on something to survive, you should be able to control it. Maybe just the threat of us coming to the US market will be like an electroshock for people to say, wait, these guys, they are just volunteers with a nonprofit with limited resources. They were able to do that. And look at the price they say they will sell it. Why is a pharma asking that much price for that?
You know, there was a time for being angry. Now that we can actually see an end to this soon, it's not anger anymore, it's just determination.
Thanks for watching this episode of Just Might Work. Subscribe to Freethink as we explore the solutions that could solve our most pressing challenges.